But will it make a difference in the public discourse about this to have credible public servants sit there and say it? This has all been sources say, intelligence leaks. There you have people with long resumes in public service and law enforcement saying this is a criminal investigation, including the president.
I think it is significant. But you know, this is different from other investigations, at least so far. You know, in Watergate, there was a special prosecutor and there was a congressional investigation. In Iran-Contra, there was a special prosecutor and there was a congressional investigation. In those congressional investigations, the witnesses were not saying, I can't talk about it because the independent counsel is investigating it. They both go on at the same time, and the public has an enormous interest in getting these facts. So if witnesses are going to come before Congress and say, we can't talk about it because the special counsel is investigating it, we'll never learn anything.
Well, and maybe they could be held in contempt of Congress. Who knows? I mean, Burr sounded upset about it. Yeah. But it seemed to me there was one message they had. We weren't directed. We weren't pressured. That was it.
The president was also from the president's perspective, he was very lucky today. It was Dan Coats, a former senator, in that chair, and Admiral Rogers, a man in uniform, in the chair. If these were two other people who didn't have, A, the military history, and B, the credibility with the United States Senate, I think they would have been pushed further in this setting. That doesn't mean they won't be pushed further down the line, but they didn't get it as hard today as they might have had it been other people.
But you were talking about the fact that you can have both investigations simultaneously, and that was their excuse. If that were their actual excuse, then at least we can have that discussion. To me, their excuse was completely, what was their excuse?
Yeah,
that was
part of
their excuse. But then it was like, at one point, the fact that Dan Coats said, I don't really know if there's a legal basis.
You have to admire his candor, if not the legal advice he's getting.
The only reasonable inference is that I don't want to say something public that would embarrass the president.
And get them in hot water with the president, right?
John McCain's moment at the end is he's sitting there with a copy of the Washington Post saying, here I'm reading it, and he called it an Orwellian existence.
Let's listen to that, Jim, because it's a great point. At the end of the, John McCain's not on the committee, but he's the chairman of the Armed Services Committee, so he gets to sit in. And at the end, he was asking his friend Dan Coats about the Washington Post story today and the director's refusal to talk about it.
You know, it just shows what kind of an Orwellian existence that we live in. I mean, it's detailed, as you know, from reading the story, as to when you met, what you discussed, et cetera, et cetera. And yet, here in a public hearing before the American people, we can't talk about what was described in detail in this morning's Washington Post. Do you want to comment on that, Dan?
Are you asking me? Comment on the integrity of the Washington Post reporting? I guess I've been around
It's pretty detailed.
I guess I've been around town long enough to not take everything at face value that's printed in the Post. I served on the committee here and often saw that information that we had been discussed had been reported, but that wasn't always accurate. I think this is the response that I gave to the Post was that I did not want to publicly share what I thought were private conversations with the President of the United States.
He doesn't know what to say at the end, because the Post story is incredibly well documented. Mm-hmm. He just won't talk about it publicly.
Right. And also at the end there, he kind of tacitly confirmed the story.
Right.
He said he didn't want to comment on conversations that, first of all, no one seems to want to acknowledge existed, but he seemed to acknowledge in that moment that they existed. He just thought they were private. Which, when you're sitting before Congress, is not a reason to not answer questions. Just because you think it's private, you don't want to talk about it, it's not a reason to not answer questions. And that's one of the reasons why you might see a Republican chairman of this committee essentially saying, You cannot do that because it undermines the very foundation of the whole point of having a Senate committee where people are sitting there, they're under oath, they're supposed to tell the truth. They have to tell the truth.
And the frustration, you could sense the Republican frustration at the end. Again, the chairman, it was brought up earlier, the chairman saying, don't come up here unless you can answer the questions. It's your job to answer the questions. Appreciate everybody coming in, a little rock and roll with all the live coverage. Thanks for joining us on Inside Politics today. We'll put